This week on Maker Update, the Echo you really want, Low Riding's new low, and the Huggy Wuggy you may need to make for Halloween. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. Hope you're all doing well. I have a lot to catch you up on, so let's get started with the project of the week. On his YouTube channel, Workshop Nation, Thomas Byrne shows how he turned a basic Amazon Echo into this sci-fi animatronic companion. I have such an unreasonable love for this project, it's important to me personally to unpack what's going on here. On the surface, it's really a mashup of some common project themes. You've got the Alexa hack angle, you've got the servo-powered 3D printed animatronic eyes, courtesy of Will Cogley's design, and then you have the repurposed retro tech with the CRT TV. And it all gels together wonderfully. Dig a little deeper though, as a maker, I'm always looking out for new tips and techniques. So I love seeing how Thomas rewired the old TV to display the audio output from the Echo. He did it by hijacking the deflection signals and connecting them to an audio amplifier. That's a technique I'm keeping in my back pocket. I was also inspired to see how he gave the animatronic eyes a face tracking capability. No Raspberry Pi, no OpenCV or TensorFlow. Instead, he dropped in a $13 board from SparkFun, available through DigiKey, called the Person Sensor. That and an Arduino is all he needs for the eyes to be able to detect and react to what's in front of it. That's another shortcut I'm sure to use in the future. But more than all of that, the video itself has a lot of heart. I can totally relate to his observation that the future we were promised is here technologically, but it's a little disappointing that it's all a bit flat and lacking in personality. We wanted C-3PO, and instead we all got AI in our pocket. The good news is, as makers, we uniquely can take our vision for AI companions that final step, and I have a strong sense that that's going to be a theme we see a lot of over the next few years. More projects. For weeks now, on social media, I've been seeing uncredited footage of this Fiat Panda that has seemingly broken the limit of lowriding and actually sunk into the ground. It's click-worthy for sure, but the actual story behind it is worth exploring. The car is a project from the Italian car hacker collective Carmageddon. On their YouTube channel, they have a two-part video series that covers all the work that went into making it happen. Of course, it's all in Italian, but here's the craziest part that you don't see in the social media clips. This thing's not remote controlled. There's an actual driver laying down inside with a throttle and a steering yoke. But because there's no visibility inside, they're using a wireless dash cam to relay the view to their phone and using that as their view. It's crazy, but I love it. On their YouTube channel, Wicked Makers show how they made this giant Huggy Wuggy animatronic for Halloween. The build is mostly made from PVC pipe covered in fur, with some extra attention paid to the head, which is carved from insulation foam and then covered in fur. Two great tips from this project that caught my eye. First, take a look at how they're able to create all this motion from a single DC windshield wiper motor. Second, check out these 3D printed joints that they use to connect all the PVC pipe limbs. Some of these screw into fixed positions, some are meant to move, and some flange out to get bolted down. It looks like a great way to play around with PVC pipe sculpture that allows you to make adjustments along the way. So many tips and tools already, but here are some more. This past week, we saw the launch of the SparkFun Experiential Robotics Platform, or XRP kit, also available on DigiKey. The kit runs around $115 and includes everything you need to make a pretty robust little programmable robot with no soldering required. Everything plugs together with pre-wired connectors. The coolest bit for me is this controller board, which marries together a Raspberry Pi Pico with a driver board for four encoded motors plus two servo connectors, an input for the included ultrasonic rangefinder, a quick port, and a few extras. On the Programming Electronics YouTube channel, there's a new video up on integrating ChatGPT into your next Arduino project. In this particular example, they're using an Arduino-compatible ESP32 board that can communicate over Wi-Fi, along with an OLED screen and a connected keyboard. It's essentially a terminal where you type in questions and get answers, but there's no reason to believe that you couldn't build on this guide to create your own Alexa replacement for your animatronic robot companion. Arguably, a Raspberry Pi may be a better solution, but if Arduino is your comfort zone, then there's a path here that works. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, a reminder that the DigiKey website has a resources section filled with every unit conversion calculator you could imagine. Resistor codes, temperature, Ohm's law, battery life, force, watts, you can even calculate the pulse width of a 555 timer. It's all there, and like everything in this video, I'll leave a link to it in the description. Alright, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment if you like. Big thanks to DigiKey Electronics for making this whole show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.